Hi guys, today I would like to talk about the Secret Church Shockwave unboxing and about the Yuzday event sacrifice on the 13th May, and also especially about the Christian persecution. And for more details, watch the video. Stay tuned. Hi guys, today I would like to talking about the Secret Church box. I was making a little unboxing video. The box is by the organization Open Doors about persecuted Christian. I just ordered this some days ago, and but I'm making just a German version of this video, and I wanted to make it also on English. No, but I hope my English is good enough to understand this one here. But I really want to making also an English one, because I'm feeling like this is an international problem. I mean, Christian persecution, and here we are. The Secret Church box. This quotation based here on the 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. We are troubled, perplexed, persecuted, cast down. And yeah, we have some different material here. Yeah, there's some information here. I will open, because it is it's closed here. I will open this later, and then I have here two bracelets. It looks really, really interesting. I mean, really cool. I like this one here. Yeah, in different sizes. And DVD about Christian persecution. No, and then we have here some cards. I mean, there's some. How can I say? I mean, like on the Shockwave event from Open Doors. It's like when the groups a so-called playing this one. I mean, it's like to simulate. I mean, the situation, like how it feels like to be to living in a secret church, or praying in a secret church here. And so it's like the group meeting at the church, and someone knocking outside from the door, and the building is a bit dark and so on. And I guess it's also really good experience here. And also here some other material here, like, I mean, how to organize here. And here you can see the sacrifice event, the youth event by Open Doors on the 13th May this year, as it is online. And I mean, okay, I use here the German screenshot here, but you can find on your searching engine also on English or some other languages here. And I mean, about this one here, I also want to talking about some different, how can I say, I mean, ways, I mean, about the Christian persecution. I mean, I give you some example here, and talking about some countries. And here from the website, you can find this one. I also use the German website, but if you're searching here on the searching engine, I mean, if you're typing Open Doors sacrifice here, I mean, you will also find an English version of this one here. Also, when I quote when I show you some Wikipedia articles. I mean, you will find this one also when you search on Wikipedia on the English version or another language here, you will find this one here. Yeah, but I want to give you also like the sources where I get this one. Yeah, but for me, I feeling like this is a really important topic about talking about persecuted Christians. I talked already in my first video about Open Doors, about like there's around 340 million persecuted and discriminated Christians, and I'm getting persecuted and discriminated in different ways. I mean, like, for example, they're getting bullets or getting threatened with violence or getting beat or also getting murdered or getting in prison. They have to leave their families, their groups. It's really different ways, and I mean, for example, here I want to show you this. For example, here about the Mandea. I mean, like this, like for example, here. I mean, if you're really a full believing Christian, I mean, you're really have self confident about, like, you don't need to impress other people or to threaten other people. I mean, you know you're right. I mean, you know you're living a good life and you're grateful to God. And I mean, for example, I mean, like the Mandea. I mean, the Mandea is a group. They're also getting persecuted, and I want to also show you some different. A bit more global, global view about this one. The Mandea here is a group, like, they are not Christian or Jewish or Muslims. Yes, they're based on the tradition by John the Baptist. And I mean, if you're really, I mean, a full believing Christian, I mean, you never have the idea like to sweating the Mandea, but I feeling like also the Mandea getting also persecuted during the Iraq War, because they are an own religious group, an own ethnic group here, and but I mean, it's also I feeling like when some groups are getting persecuted, I mean, for example, like some Muslim groups, for example, like the Uyghuric people in China, or some other places. I mean, like in Bangladesh, or in Burma, or Virginia, they're getting persecuted. I mean, it's also to talking about this one. Now, and you're seeing persecution, I mean, also in different ways. I mean, for example, here about the Kora Church here in Istanbul. This is just only one example here, like some kind of, how can I say? I mean, like to treating Christian faith, I mean, different. I mean, like, to not giving the Christian groups not the same rights. I mean, like, you see this on the news, like, to, like, for example, the Hagia Sophia, the Kora Church here, and like from the newspaper from Switzerland, Neue Zürcher Zeitung, they're writing about the sad sisters from Hagia Sophia, because there's not the only church, like there's also some other churches here, for example, in Iznik, like, because the Iznik, I mean, this is also an old Christian church. I mean, Iznik is Nikia. I hope I pronounce it right. I mean, this is also Iznik have an old Christian history and tradition here. And I mean, they are using the churches now as mosque, and I'm feeling like it's a bit like all the icons and all the pictures are getting covered by some sheets, and I'm feeling like, I don't know. And it's like, I mean, why don't getting the Christians? I mean, that's also like some Orthodox Christian. Why don't they can getting the churches? So. No, but I mean, but this is my own opinion here. But I mean, I sometimes feeling like they are doing this one just only to distract for their own problems. I mean, like for example, high rate of unemployment people. So okay, to find someone who's the fault for this. Ah, yeah, we protect the Christians because they are always the bad guys. I mean, like, for example, also the next example here is about China. I mean, like, there's also a big group, I mean, a big Christian group here. And from the statistics from Professor Zhang for sociology, they expected a group by 247 million Christian people here and around 160 million Protestants at this time. And so the Christians are not just only a minority there. But you will also see sometimes that the Christians are here getting some problems. I mean, like, for example, some churches are getting closed. For example, some priests are getting in prison, or some people who are selling Christian books have having some problems, because the Bible is a book in China that there's no legal status. I mean, you cannot just buy somewhere a Bible, or it's not like you can just order somewhere. And it's a really, I guess, a really difficult situation. But I also seen like on some news here, like they're changing the scriptures here. I mean, from the government to changing a bit in their own way. And I also feeling like, oh my God, I mean, like, I don't know how to say. I mean, like, I also getting a bit, how can I say, a bit angry, like in Germany, when some people changing the Bible just in their own way, not based on the translation, it just based on their own way. And I'm feeling like, oh my God, I mean, like, is this not the one it should be like this? And you can see here the Protestant Christians are getting the major Christian group in China, behind the Catholic group. You will see, I mean, some different about this one, but actually, if you're Christian, okay, like, yeah, I try to see you, I mean, in general, as Christians, not like he's Protestant or Orthodox or Catholic or so on. I don't try to, I mean, I really try to see you just as brothers and sisters, and not liking in groups. I mean, like, and because actually also when something happens, I mean, also like terrorist groups, I mean, like in some place like in Indonesia or Sri Lanka or so on, they're not asking like, hey, are you Catholic or Protestant or so on? They're just attacking this here cross. They're attacking. And and here also some example here about like, like about how is, people are sweating here. And the next example here is about the murdering of the martyr Nabi Habashi Salama. Mr. Salama was a trader from Egypt. He trading some luxuries, and he also he built an own church in Egypt, but yeah, he getting kidnapped by the terroristic Islamic IS group, and he, as far as I know, I seen here that he was also tortured here for a long time, and then he was murdered by this terroristic group. And I mean, like, yeah, you see, actually, I don't know exactly, I mean, what they want to do. I mean, like, I cannot understand, I mean, like, how to show the world they can kill some innocent unarmed man. Yeah, it's really terrible. I mean, I'm feeling so sad about him. But you also see, I mean, like the second source they are talking about it, Egypt police, they have also some trouble, and they killed three of those terrorists here. They're getting involved in this one year, and I mean, you see, I mean, like, that if you're doing some violence, you are getting some violence back, and it's like exactly like this. I mean, this kind of people killing innocent people, and I mean, what is about this? I mean, do you feeling like you're brave or I don't know. I mean, this is really actually absolutely low life, and there's no heroic, there's no heaven. I mean, for this kind of action. I mean, this is, I mean, like, if you read the Quran, I mean, like, not the people who are not believing in God is actually the worst groups for Islamic people who believe in Allah. Not the non-Muslims are the worst group. Actually, the Muslim group who perverted the Quran, who perverted the Islam faith, they are the worst group. In the way, I mean, from the Quran. I mean, if they would read, they actually, all what the Quran forbids, they did actually. I mean, to killing innocent people, to killing unarmed people, all of this. And I also mean, No, but this is another topic. But if you see, I mean, like, also, like for example, like, Muslim groups are also like to getting, for example, persecuted, like the Uyghurs or the Rohingya from Burma. I mean, like, also, like, for example, the Muslim countries are getting showing solidarity. I mean, showing supportive about this one. But I mean, later, I mean, when they're having some, I mean, when the country is having some kind of contract, some trading, economical reasons, like, no, I never hear about this one. I mean, then the Uyghuric people are getting forgotten. I mean, this is actually, but I mean, also, like, I don't want you to point fingers, but actually also like Germany for Christian groups, I don't want to be double standard. I mean, this is also the same, like, when Christians, like, for example, in Africa, no one cares, like, so this is the same way, and I feeling like we should getting not doing this again. I mean, like, not to continue this way of thinking, like, because I'm feeling like all of this people, I mean, like, who live in the Christian faith are my brothers and sisters, and not like, this is a good Christians or that is a bad Christians. I mean, like, just because, like, living there or living here, I mean, this is not like a real, I'm not sure, but I feel like this is not a real thinking to measure Christian people just only by this. And I also want to show you about, I mean, like, for example, like in Germany, I mean, like, okay, I have talking about some countries here already, but I mean, you will see also some kind of yeah, they are not living. They have a Christian face, like also like how can I say, like in a good way. I mean, like for example, like the Roman Catholic Church, Saint Lambertus from Imerat halt. If you can search this also on some searching engines here, Imerat Dom, and this was actually demolished. I mean, the church was demolished because the brown coal in the near from this place, and the some company want to getting this brown coal, and the village and the church is in, yeah, just on the way, and they have to demolish all this one here, and there was also some protest here, but I mean, okay, I mean, I feeling this is also really not good. I mean, for example, if you're going to, yeah, I mean, like, just only because of this, they demolished some church, and also, I don't care, I mean, it's a Protestant or Catholic or so on, because I like all of the churches, and, but this is also, to show you, also to focus, I mean, like, to focus international, I mean, to have your eyes on international news, and also in front of your doors, I mean, in your own country, in your own village. I mean, this is to have open eyes for this one here. And I mean, like, for example, I living for one, yeah, 5-6 months in Romania, and I mean, to compare to this one, I'm not kidding here. If you're going to Romania, maybe in just some small villages here, but in the big cities, you will not seeing a rotten, a trashy church. I mean, like, rotten church, you will not see this one here. Because, I mean, okay, I mean, also in Romania, not everything is good, or not everything is okay, no? Okay, but I'm feeling like they're living the Christian life a bit more, they have another status. I mean, they really like to show their churches and have respect for this one. And in Germany, a lot of churches are really getting demolished, or they are just really rotten already. And I really disagree about this idea. I mean, like here, for example, the church from Cluj and from Brasov, I mean, this is also a evangelical church, and from Cluj is an Orthodox church here. I mean, I really like to see the different churches, and I really recommend, I mean, to going abroad, I mean, to going to Romania. It's a really beautiful country, but I wanted to show you, I mean, like, to learning, I mean, like, also when you're learning about other groups, I mean, like, I mean, it doesn't matter, I mean, you can learning from Mandean people, you can learning from other European countries here, and I want to show you about, like, to have an open eyes. I mean, like for the persecuted Christian brothers and sisters, and also, I mean, to have open eyes for your own country. So now we are already at the end of my video. I hope you enjoy this one here. If you like my video, then I would please you to like and to subscribe my video on my channel here. You can also find me on Facebook and on Instagram. And then I wish you and your friends and your family all the love in the world. Stay healthy. God bless you. And I hope we will see us again.